My name is James, and today I'm going to show you how to build a Tuna blimp.
So first thing first, we have safety first. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the feather out of the packaging. All right, and so the next step is to get the female pins out of the bag. What I like to do is line them up, just put them in the pins. And if you just lie it flat, it'll love itself. The next step we're going to do is set up the soldering iron. First, we have some water, and we're going to soak the sponge with it. I'm going to go ahead and turn on the soldering iron. And I'm going to wait for it to come up to temp to 350. The next step is we're going to solder each of these pins. And they're gonna come out looking like happy little pine trees. I'm gonna start soldering the feather. So right there, I touched the soldering iron to both the pin pad and the pin. And I should have a little soldering joint right there. And then I'm going to go ahead and do that for the rest of these pins. While you're soldering, you should be careful not to breathe in the fumes. If you have a fan, it'd be best to turn it on or open a window. So if you have excess material on your soldering iron like this, it's best to wipe it off on the sponge and getting it off, and so you have a nice clean tip. So while soldering this, the technique I like to use is just placing the soldering iron directly right on both the pads and the pins, and then just moving the solder into it so that it fills the joint, and then I raise the soldering iron up. I just continue to the next one. And I want to also make sure that when I fill the solder in, that the pad on the board is completely covered. And that might take a little extra time, so you just leave your soldering iron on the pad for a little extra bit, and then it should automatically flow to it. I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next side. Alright, after a closer inspection, the first four that I did didn't have an adequate amount of solder on it, so I'm going to show you how to add more solder to that. So as you can see here, that these are more so filled in, and this one right here, you can still see the pad, you can still see the hole. And so to fix that, we're just going to add more solder to this. So another scenario might be where the opposite is happening, where you have too much solder on two joints and they're connected. So those two joints are clearly connected. And so what I would do is remove any excess solder you have, and then try to place the soldering iron between these two joints, and then try to pull back. If there's too much solder, repeat rinsing the soldering iron and melting it and pulling back. Almost got it. And this may take a couple tries because you're just trying to remove the soldering from the excess until you have those two pins separated. All right, so here we're going to flip the board over and insert the male pins. So we're going to insert the long male pins into the long side and the short male pins into the short side. There we are. So what we're going to do here is we're going to prepare the voltage regulator. And to do so, we're also going to grab two JST 3-pin wires and another JST power cable. I'm going to grab the wire spool, and from that I'm going to take the red wire, and I'm also going to take the black wire. And generally the red wire signifies for high voltage and the black wire signifies low voltage. I'm going to cut the wires approximately to the length of the JSTs. And then I have my two wires. So we're going to take the voltage regulator and we're going to cut off the red end because the red end is the battery side of the voltage regulator, where it takes the 7.4 volts from the battery and converts it to 5 volts for the rest of the system. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this side off. And I'm going to go ahead and strip these wires to about a centimeter length. It doesn't have to be exact. And you want to use the 28 American wire gauge when you do this. All right. What I like to do when they first come out of the cable is I like to twist the wires together because when they come out of the sheath, they're all frayed. And we want them to be very close together. For this side, we're going to take the power cable and two 3-pin JSTs. We're going to go ahead and strip these wires and prepare them for soldering. For this one, we are going to use a 24 American wire gauge. We're just going to strip the ends off these JST wires. And again, we're going to use a 28 American wire gauge for this. And if you accidentally cut it, it's no big deal. Just go ahead and strip the next length of cable. Like that. If you accidentally cut it, just go ahead and strip the next centimeter off the cable. It's no big deal. There we go. And now we have all our cables stripped. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the voltage regulator again. So we're just going to take all the red leads. Line them up. And we're just going to go ahead and twist all these wires together. And what we can do is we can take our little solder wire holder, place them all neatly in there so you don't have to hold the wires yourself. And we're going to solder these wires together. What I like to do is I like to turn it 90 degrees from me, so that way I have clear paths for the solder and the soldering iron. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make sure that the wires are completely covered and soaked through with solder. So I'm going to go around the bottom with the soldering iron, and I'm also going to go around the top to ensure I have full coverage of the wires. So after we've done this, we can go ahead and do the black side. Pull the black wires. And we're just going to do the same thing we did with the red side. I'm going to twist all the wires together. Place it in the wire holder. I'm just going to go ahead and solder that together. So again, I'm just going to soak it with solder. And I'm going to go around the back side as well. And again, be careful not to breathe in these fumes. All right. So once I have my connections, I'm going to go ahead and slightly separate them, so that I have the power cable on this side and everything else separate. And I'm going to go ahead and wrap these in electrical tape. So I'm going to use my wire cutters to go ahead and cut this. That notch, I'll tear it off. I'm just going to go ahead and cover this. And I'm going to go ahead and do that the red side as well. So I'm going to tear that off. Go ahead and wrap this side as well. And I want to make sure all the exposed wire is covered. So the next thing, again, we're going to go back to the voltage regulator. And this time we're going to cut the white bit off. There we go. And again, we're going to strip these wires. Right. And that means we're also going to have to strip all these other cables, the last two cables. But make sure to strip both ends. And we're also going to strip the wires on the JSTs. So again, we're just going to grab all the red wires, line them up, and twist them all together. Yep. Go ahead and put them in our wire holder. And we're going to solder them together. So again, just going to melt some solder onto here. And I'm going to go from the bottom as well. And we're also going to do that with the black wires. And twist. And this strand of wire is a bit long, so I'm just going to trim it down. And place it in my wire holder. And solder these wires together as well. Go from the top and as well from the bottom. And then we're going to also wrap the exposed wires with electrical tape. Alright, now we're ready to attach our cable bundle to the male pins on the feather. And this is the feather. And using the cable one we made earlier, we're going to attach the exposed wires to the male pins on the feather. So what I'm going to do right now is straighten up these wires and twist them so that they don't get frayed. And I'm going to take my wire wrapping tool, and I'm going to attach these wires as displayed on the diagram on the instructions. I'm going to start off with the red wire, and I'm going to poke it through the top hole on the wire wrapping tool. And I know it's in because the wire came out the other side. So I'm going to go ahead and look for the USB pin. All right. And you should follow closely with the wiring diagram to know which pin this is. I'm going to go ahead and slide this wire tool onto the pin that we want to attach this wire to. And I'm just going to go ahead and twist. With this, we should have the wire wrapped around the pin. And now that the wire is wrapped around the pin, I'm going to go ahead and solder that wire. Just like so. And I'm going to do this with the rest of the cables according to the wiring diagram. So now we're done preparing the feather, and we'll move on to preparing the motors. So we're going to prepare the motors now. To do that, we're going to first wire up the two motors we're going to use for the lips or the tuna fish. We're just going to strip these three wires and solder the JSD connector to it. And for the motors, it doesn't matter which cable connects to which, so you can just go ahead and tie these together. And I'm just going to go ahead and quickly solder these together. Now I'm just going to cover the exposed wires with electrical tape. All right, that's one motor done. Now we're just going to go ahead and do the same thing for the next one. Just like the motors, we're going to prepare the servo. But this time the color matters. So we're going to have black to black, red to red, and yellow to white. Just going to go ahead and cut off the header that the servo comes with. And strip the cables and solder them together. So white to yellow. Twist them together. Just going to go ahead and solder them. Going on to the red wires. And finally the black wires. I highly recommend using the wire holder when soldering because these wires are blistering hot. And I'm just gonna go ahead and cover these. All right, now that we're done preparing the servo, we can move on to preparing the batteries. All right. So here we have the battery, and then we have the 2-pin JST over here. So what I'm going to do right now is, on the wire that has the do not pull tag, I'm just going to have pull on it and get it loose. And for this operation, only cut one of these wires with a yellow pin header at a time. If you cut both of them at the same time, you have a chance of connecting the two wires together of the battery and creating a short, which could damage the battery and make it cease to function. Just going to go ahead and cut the red wire. Strip it. And I'm going to go ahead and strip the JST as well. So with these two wires exposed, again, I'm just going to twist these wires together. And solder the connection together. Again, I recommend using the soldering wire holder to hold these wires in place for you. And so I'm also going to ensure that this connection isn't capable of touching the black wires by covering this connection entirely with electrical tape. So now I'm going to go ahead and cut the black side. Strip it. And strip the black JST as well. And again, I'm going to twist the two wires together, solder it. And since these are thick wires, you're going to want to apply a decent amount of solder to get them fully covered. And lastly, we're just going to cover it with electrical tape. And if you have a bit of exposed wire, go ahead and take another piece of electrical tape. Just go ahead and cover it up. And that's the battery fully assembled. Now that we have all the electronics assembled, we're going to start putting them together with the 3D prints so that we can mount them to the blimp. First things first, I have the servo and the servo mount. I'm just going to slide the wire through the servo holder, and it should fit flush right there. Then in the servo package, we're going to take the screws and we're going to take this servo header that's two pegs on both sides. Go ahead and screw one of the black screws in the hole between the servo and the servo mount to ensure that it's securely inside. Moving on, we take the servo header and go ahead and put it on the gear, taking the silver screw and also screwing it down. Right. Next, we can mount the motor to the motor mount for the servo. And in case that there's any strings from the 3D print, go ahead and just take your Allen key and poke through these holes real quick. And what we're going to want to do is align the bottom of the motor with the 3D print in the baggie that came with the motors. We're going to go ahead and take the smaller screws, put them on the Allen wrench, and pre-screw it through the 3D print. Until that it starts poking through. That way you can see it. You're going to want to align this hole up with the screw. Wait to feel the bump and just start screwing it in. So with one align, we're just going to go ahead and put the rest of the screws in. And you want to go in a cross pattern. Alright. And that's all the screws. And now we're going to attach the propeller to the motor. Going to go ahead and slide this on to the middle hole, and then you want to look down into it and align the screw holes with the holes at the top, making sure to push down all the way, and we're just going to go ahead and screw these in. That the motor's fully installed. We're just going to go ahead and take this piece and align the 3D print with the servo header. And it should just slide right on. And then we can take the opposite piece, this piece right here, and slide this on the back side. And we're going to take the last black screw from the servo kit, and we're just going to go ahead and screw these parts together to ensure that they're fully stable. There we go. And then for the other motor, we're going to take the vertical 3D print and mount it with the screws included. I'm going to go ahead and pre-screw this one just through the print. And then align it up with the screw hole and go all the way. And then in a cross-like pattern, we're going to continue screwing the rest of the screws into the motor. Alright, now the motor is attached to the 3D print. We're going to go ahead and attach the propeller to it. Again, I'm going to line up those screw holes and screw the propeller in. All right. And that's all our components assembled. And they're ready to be attached to the blimp. Now we can go on to programming the feather and assembling the Tuna blimp. Now that we have all the components assembled, I'm going to show you how to join all the connectors. Starting from the feather, we have the wire connected to pin 27. Let's get that. And since this is the only wire that's connected to the 5-volt side on the 5-volt regulator, this means it's connected to the servo. Right here. And then the next wire is going to be the wire connected to pin 33. We're going to go ahead and connect an ESC to it and connect it to the motor attached to the servo. And the last wire, we're going to again attach another ESC, because for every motor we have, we need an ESC with it. And this goes to the last remaining motor. The last thing to do would be to connect the battery. And when you plug in the battery, both ESCs should light blue. And you should hear the tone of 6 beeps. But because this feather is not programmed, we only heard 3 beeps. And now I would recommend going to the software guide and programming the feather. When filling up the envelope, it's very helpful to have a second pair of hands to help you out. So, hey Adrian, you mind giving me a hand? So what we're gonna just do is screw this loose to open it counterclockwise. Look for the opening in the valve and go ahead and slide it on the nozzle. So you wanna straighten this out because otherwise it's gonna let out a high-pitched noise. And you're just gonna go ahead and bend the nozzle and start inflating the helium. What you're looking for with a fully inflated envelope is that it has a bit of give, but it still feels pretty taut to the touch. You can still press your hand into it, but you don't want to be able to press your hand into it too much. Please inflate your balloons inside, otherwise you may lose them to the outdoors. And as a reminder, please do not inhale helium. It could lead to a stroke. Now that we have our blimp fully inflated, we could attach our parts to the blimp. We're gonna start taping the components to the blimp, but before we do that, we're going to tape down some wires just to ensure that the motors don't cut the wires when they're running. So I'm just going to go ahead and tape this wire down to the side. And I might actually take another piece, tape, and just tape all these wires down. And for as well as this 3D print, I'm going to go ahead and tape the wire to the extra piece of length that we have. Just so that the wire can't be cut by the motor. And I'm also going to put two pieces of tape on the back of the feather so that the pins at the back don't have a possibility of popping the envelope. Sorry, I want to check something. All right. Go ahead and do this on this side as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with the end piece. All right. We're going to take a bunch of tape and maybe cut a bunch of tape just preemptively so that we have it. What we're going to do is start with the back and tape a piece onto it. We're going to apply it to the very back center point, right here. And in case it's sagging a little bit, you want it to be straight. So just keep using a bit extra bit of tape to make sure that it's straight with the blimp. There we go. We're going to attach the feather right here at the underbelly. And take a big piece of tape. Go ahead and tape it down, or tape it up. And then next, we're going to attach the bottom motor to the underbelly. So, and then the last piece what we're going to do is we're going to take the battery on. All right. Now we can see that, take a shot of the underbelly to show how all the components are taped on. So we have the up-down motor. Then we have the battery. We have the feather. And then we have the servo and motor at the back. Now that we have all the components on the blimp, Adrian, if you'd be so kind to let go, we'll notice that the components are weighing all of it down to one side. So to counteract that, we're going to add Play-Doh to the front of it. And we want to let just enough Play-Doh so that it's positively buoyant or neutrally buoyant to carry all those components on. If you have any problems with the balance of the blimp, what you can do is you can also adjust the components, such as moving the components towards the front, so that way it'll start to balance out. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take the battery off and try to realign it more so to the front. It still connects. Going to line up more evenly. We've built our Tuna blimp. If you want to build the other two blimps, please refer to the instructions on the website.